Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve the error the term G++ is not recognized as the name of a cmdlet in Visual Studio Code. So let's get started. So first thing what you need to do is you need to go to the folder where you have installed min-gwo. So by default it is present in this PC local disk C, and you'll be having min-gwo over here. So if you aren't able to figure out where you have installed min-gwo, what you are doing is just go to your search over here and type min-gwo, and you will be getting this min-gwo installation manager. Just click on open file location. It will be taking you to this particular icon or application over here. So what you are doing is right click on it again and just click open file location. So this will directly take you to the min-gwo folder. As you can see here, if I just now click it, I'll be just getting the same path again. So in this min-gwo folder, you need to go to the folder bin. I need to just copy this particular path. It's c min-gwo and bin. So let me just now copy it. And if you aren't having bin folder in this min-gwo folder, you need to go to any particular folder and search for bin. All right. In some cases, it will be present inside another folder as well. So just copy this path and go to environmental variables. And you'll be getting this one. Just click edit environmental variables, and you'll be having this system variables over here. Just click on this path and just click edit, just click on new again and just paste it. It is c min-gwo and bin, and just click okay here as well. And after doing that, super important thing, close your Visual Studio Code and open it again so that the changes are getting affected. So I will just close it now and reopen it again. So now I have again opened my Visual Studio Code, and if I just now type G++-V. So here you can see I will be getting the version over here, and even I can run and compile my program. So I will just type G++, my program name is newpro.cpp. Yeah, it is compiling fine. And in order to view the output, I'll put ./a. And here you can see I'm getting this particular output over here. So I hope you have found this video useful. I have also done many other programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos off my channel, subscribe me, thanks for watching.